CHAPS has encouraged more men to get tested for HIV. It's really important that targeted HIV prevention work continues into the future.
We've got the research. We've got gay men with us. We have people with HIV with us. And we've got to persuade the government that that is such a valuable resource that saves lives day in, day out. And of course, we've got to continue investing in it.
CHAPS has made far more men aware of PEP.
Nobody really knew about PEP. And we know that at the beginning of that campaign, maybe 3% of gay men knew about PEP. Afterwards, we're looking around 60, 70% of men know about PEP now.
Its campaigns have always been evidence-based. It's used a social marketing model before social marketing was an accepted discipline.
It's had a massive impact in terms of the sector, that a group of agencies have been able to come together and work in partnership and can put together something like Making It Count.
And the new Making It Count 4 really talks about that whole idea of the choices men have, empowering men to make choices about their own lives. And I think that's really important. If we can continue to empower men to make choices, I hope and I believe that they can make better choices for themselves in the long run. And I think that's why it's important to continue what we do.
It's a personal highlight. I think walking into a bar in Spain in about, this would have been the late 1990s, and seeing CHAPS posters translated into Spanish and thinking, we did that, and it's being used the world over, and isn't that